Now, at this point, some of you may be saying, wait a minute, aren't there limits to how much change we can accept as a culture and as a tradition? We're facing assimilation and declining affiliation rates. Aren't there more important issues for the Jewish community to address than circumcision? Besides, circumcision has always been seen as the primary emblem of Jewish identity. If such an essential commandment is now considered optional, what's left? The reality is that whether anyone likes it or not, circumcision is no longer a given in the Jewish community.
My husband and I are both Jewish, but like a growing number of Jewish families in the United States, Israel, and elsewhere, we decided not to circumcise.
We are both physicians, and based on our experiences witnessing circumcisions in the hospital and at Briss's, we never really had much of a conversation because it was totally clear to us that we would not be doing that to our sons.
I spared my son, and I am so glad that I was able to have that awareness to do that and that he wasn't scarred in that way. Because the idea that just because something is young, that it doesn't feel, or that feeling is just going to heal, is naive and is counter to anything that we really know when we investigate with our intelligence, when we know what trauma does now.
Today, Jews all over the world that inform themselves about it increasingly do not have it done.
Parents here, globally really, are increasingly choosing to keep their boys intact, just as they do their girls. As a Jewish American, I'm particularly proud of the Brit Shalom movement, in which some Jewish parents even are choosing to forego a procedure for which there's an unimaginable amount of pressure within the community, and to welcome their children into the community with no act of violence.
Brit Shalom is a term that we use. It means a covenant of peace, and it's used instead of the Brit Milah, the covenant through circumcision.
Jews in Israel and all over the world, in ever-growing numbers, choose to leave their sons intact. Thanks to all the information that was revealed to me that day, my wife and I also decided to leave our son intact, so I called the Dr. Mohel and canceled the scheduled circumcision.
I come with my baby. My one-and-a-half-year-old, he's growing up intact in Israel. There's a whole generation of intact babies, thousands of intact babies all across the nation.
As a Jewish man who has had this crime committed against him, I don't want to continue this to another generation.
I made a wrong choice. And I want him to be able to make better choices in his life than I did. Loving and protecting my child is the most important piece of my life. And I hope if I ever get grandchildren, which is something I may get in the future if I get them, I will know better how to be better.
I was raised Jewish. A bris was just part of my upbringing, that was just expected. But when I was pregnant, and I researched circumcision, and I decided there's no way I was going to do that, and that there was no way I was going to do violence to my child. And so it was very hard for my family to accept at first. They thought he couldn't be Jewish then, and I told him that's not true. If he wanted to be Jewish, he could be Jewish. And there was, you know, he didn't need to be circumcised to be Jewish. Through the pregnancy, there was denial, there was arguments, but after he was born and they saw him, and I did everything I can to make his welcoming into the world completely nonviolent and completely gentle and welcoming, and then there was no way I was going to do violence to him after that. So they did accept it after he was born.
How old is your son now?
He's 27.
And can we talk with him?
Oh, he's very happy. I did not do that to him. He's very, very happy.
I'm Jewish, and I'm uncut, and I think it's better that way.
I have five boys. Two of them, the oldest, are circumcised, and the three of them are intact. The big one is almost 21. He's going to the army. Now it's near Gaza. no problem at all. Kids can manage with their foreskin in Israel. It's no problem at all. It's only some myth that that it's a problem for them.
אם את מוכנה לעשות סקס עם מישהו שהוא לא נימול.
כן, אני תשובה
חד משמעית,
כן.
האם את מוכנה לעשות סקס עם מישהו שהוא לא נימול?
כן.
את מוכנה לעשות סקס עם מישהו שהוא לא נימול?
כן.